All right, amazing. Thank you very much for having you here today, Pelly, and I'm so grateful today. Unfortunately, my partner, Fatima Hassan, is not here today, but I'm going to be hosting you, and I'm so grateful to have you here today. And then normally what we do in this page is all we talk about is growth, self-development, and how we can inspire and motivate someone out there. And then we invite people every Monday to come on here and then share their stories. Because a story can change someone, because a story, what it does is it distracts you. And then also you started disputing within yourself and then start asking yourself, if Pelly can do it, if Pelly can make it all the way here, yes, I can do it. So this is why we're here today. And then you can inspire those audience and then motivate them. I'll tell you a bit about Pelly. She's a very good sister of mine, and I love her so much. You know,
I love you too, bro.
Mother, from the island of French Polynesia. And Pelly Humpkins is from the beautiful island of Samoa, which is in the French Polynesia.
Yes, in the Pacific Island, yeah.
And I love those girls in the Pacific Island. And he is affectionately known as Pelly, which means sweetheart. Wow, I love that. In her native Samoa name, language. Pelly is a retired United States Army combat veteran who served humbly and distinctively for 19 years. And 19 years of various organizations and development before retiring as a surgeon first class in October 2013. And today, Pelly is number one bestseller author and an international bestseller of author of The Heart of a Warrior. A humble, you see that book, A Heart of a Warrior, you know. And she is a contributing author to the 8 best-selling international best-selling analogies books, and founder of Pelly Inspire, Embracing Authentic Love and Widows and Devoted Mothers of 4 Lovely Children, Nicole Dean, and then you have Nicole Dean Junior, Victoria, and Isabella. Yeah. So today, Pelly, there's a little bit introduction about Pelly, and then, you know, Pelly can tell us more about herself, and then we're so happy to have you here today in this platform. And I know you have a great story. And then recently, you know, she met her role model, her mentor, Les Brown, which is really powerful and profound. So Pelly, I want you to tell the audience today your story. What made you the woman you are today? What changed your life? How did you make it all the way, despite the fact what you've been through? Because I know your story into details. So what made you that woman standing power with power today, and then saying to yourself that you can do it? And then what would you tell the audience today so you can inspire and motivate them? I want you to share your story with our audience today, Talk to Connect, so they can also learn from it and be motivated and be inspired and said to themselves, if Pelly can make it, I can make it. Because most of people have already put the blanket on themselves, or they, you know, they just think that they give up in life, and their life shouldn't be like that. What will you tell our audience about your story today? So the mic is on yours now. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Well, you know, first of all, I always want to give God all the honor, praise, and glory, you know, and I always love to do that, because if it weren't for God's love, mercy, and grace, I know I would have never made it this far in life. And I just, you know, want to give him all that honor, praise, and glory, you know, and his grace, you know, is, I know for me, God's grace is sufficient for me. It's sufficient for you. It's sufficient for all of us. And, you know, and I want to thank you and Sister Fatima, you know, for this. I always call every opportunity I get a golden opportunity. That you know, being a blessing to other people. And I just encourage everyone to be a blessing to others. So I want to say hello to, you know, all our audience who's listening, Talofa, which is hello in my Samoan language. So if you're hearing me, you're in here, let's go, put, you know, type in Talofa in a comment box, T-A-L-O-F-A. And so, yes, it's Monday Motivational. It's Motivational Monday. It's a Monday where we inspire and empower, you know, hearts and souls, you know, in this platform. And I'm so grateful, you know, Alu, for this, you know, platform that you guys have, you know, so people can, people like me, you know, can come up here and share my story about how far, you know, God brought me through. And like you said, you know, if I can do it, anybody can do it. And I encourage everyone to believe that, you know, I am a living testimony of what God can do for you, because this right here, this book right here, this is my first solo project. And it took a lot for me, you know, to be here. It took a lot for me to name this book Heart of a Warrior, because I said to myself, you know, of all that I have been through, I had a lot of heart, you know, I had that heart, you know, and it took a lot of heart for me to make it through this far in life. And I want you to know that you have that heart too. Yes, you do. You just got to feel that heart. You know what I mean? And so what is Pele's story? Pele's story, my story is a story of losses. I've lost a lot in my life. I lost the father of my children 16 years ago. When Deanie passed, my oldest, Nicole, was 8 years old. Dean Jr., my son, my only son, was 6, and Victoria was 18 months. And it was hard. At the time, I was a full-time soldier. I was already a full-time mother and a full-time student while serving this nation. And believe it or not, I wanted to give up. When I instantly became that widow, when I became, you know, that single mother, I was like, man, I don't know how I'm gonna do it. I just want to quit, you know. So fast forward on, Dean was in a coma for 6 months. And those 6 months, you know what I was doing for the whole 6 months? I was asking God for a miracle. You know, for 6 months, you know, I was praying, I was fasting. I believed that God was this miracle working God, right? And I just didn't feel that when Dean passed after 6 months, you know, of being in a coma. And so what happened was, you know, my life shattered, you know, because now I've lost the love of my life. You know, he was the stay-home father, you know, and that was the agreement I had asked him to stay home with my children, with our children, because we had bad babysitters at the time, and we didn't trust anyone with our children. And so me being in the military and he was a civilian, this was the decisions that we as parents had to come together and say, hey, you know, this is what you got to do. So when Dini passed, I honestly didn't know what to do with my children, because I was always on the go with the Army. I was, you know, in the field. I was always serving. It's like I was leaving. I leave to go to work. You know, kids are sleeping. I come home, kids are sleeping. And guess what? That's all he was doing was, you know, taking care of my, I didn't have to worry about anything with my family. And I was just so grateful to God, you know, for a loving husband, for a husband that was always there for us, you know, at all times. And so when he passed, I was like, oh my goodness, like what in the world I'm going to do? And with my journey, you will know that I'm very transparent and authentic with my journey. So guess what? When Dean passed, I honestly did not know how to discipline my kids. That's the truth. Because like I said, I was always on the go. And so I was dealing with a lot, right? And so now another bad, terrible thing that happened to me was I turned to alcohol as a solution to my problems. right? So that was my friend. You know, that was my best friend, as a matter of fact. And so I was mad at God. I didn't want to hear anything about God. I turned from him. I didn't want to go to church. I stopped praying. I stopped fasting. I stopped, or sometime down the line, you know, when Dean had passed, and then I had a picture of my children on the side of my nightstand. I turned around and I was like, man, I'm looking at the picture of my children. I immediately said to myself, girl, you have three beautiful children, you know, to live for. So I, at that moment, got on my knees and I asked God for forgiveness. I asked him to forgive me for turning on him, forgive me. And I was like, who am I? You know, who am I to turn from God? And so, you know, it was really hard for me then. And 10 years after my husband passed, I was able to find love. And I encourage anyone on here, you know, when you come to that point where you lost a loved one, I encourage you to believe that there's still love out there, that you can love again, because it happened to me. And I want you to know that it's possible. And so, unfortunately, you know, I went through a divorce, you know, and that divorce got me to where I am today. Meaning, when I went through that divorce, I didn't let my divorce, you know, keep me down. And that was another thing too. When I was, you know, starting to have marital problems and all that, I turned to alcohol again, right? And so it was really not good, because alcohol was my friend, you know, at the time. But guess what? I am proud to share with you that today, like today, the 19th of September, is my day 261 days of no alcohol and no soda. It is 260 days of making that lifetime commitment to my health, you know, making that lifetime commitment to myself, you know, and to my children, because they are my big why, you know, in life. And so, yes. So, you know, after I lost Dean, went through a divorce, I lost both of my parents. And I encourage anyone on here, if you still have a parent or parents still living, I encourage you to love on them. This is your time. This is your time to love on your parents, because when they're gone, you know, it's a different life. Like for me, and I everything I share with you, it's all from experience. I don't just, you know, fabricate any story or anything. I am sharing you what I have been through and what God has brought me through. And so, yeah, you know, it's different. My life has, you know, my life hasn't been the same since, you know, my parents passed. You know, my father passed 10 years ago, and my mom, you know, passed this girl. But it's something when your mother is gone, you know, because that's your confidant, that's your, you know, that's your go-to, just everything. And I really miss both of my parents. So yes, that's my journey. My journey is a journey of losses. But as I, you know, have journeyed along, I now call my journey a breathtaking journey. And so I'm gonna read, you know, because I came up with a acronym for breathtaking journey. And I wanna read an excerpt from my book. And I said, I am thankful and grateful for my parents and grandparents who gave me life and paved the way for me to succeed. I owe them my life, faith, and my breathtaking journey. So the B for me was blessed beyond measure. R, I am that resilient warrior. E, I, in my journey, yes, I have an empowered life now. A, authentically me, whom God created me to be. T, thankful for all of God's blessings. H, humble servant. T, tenacity for life. A, attitude of gratitude. K, yes, I am a kind-hearted servant. I, inspire the world. And that's exactly what I'm doing today. And every time I get on somebody's platform, I love to inspire and empower the world. And never give up on life. I didn't give up on me. And I encourage you not to give up on you. G, God's love, mercy, and grace got me here today. Journey, the J for me, I have a joyful heart. And it took a lot for me to have this kind of heart. And you know, when you have that joy, it's not any old kind of joy, it's that unspeakable joy. O is I am a once in a lifetime kind of woman. And I want you to know you are that too. You are that once in a lifetime kind of man, and you are once in a lifetime kind of woman. You, unafraid of life experiences. Yes, do everything unafraid. You know why? Because there's hope out there. There's love out there. And there's people like, you know, Brother Alu, like me, you know, who loves you enough to be, you know, here to help you, you know, share some nuggets and everything of how God brought us through, you know, so you can be inspired, so you can be empowered, so you can, you know, take charge of your life. And so the R is rejoicing in the Lord always. I love to do that every day. That's how I live my life. You know, always rejoicing him, always giving God all the honor and praise and glory, because if it weren't for him, we won't be here today, right? And the and, guess what? And is naturally beautiful. I don't wear makeup because I it's just me, right? I am naturally beautiful inside and out. And I want you to know that you are too. You are that naturally beautiful soul. And E, equipped by God. God has equipped me to be his servant, to serve him with all of my heart and with a whole lot of love. And I encourage you to do the same, because when you serve with all of your heart and with all of your love for what you do, that's when you know that your purpose in life is aligned with what God is calling you. And that's what I love to do. That's why I love what I do, and I do it because I love it. And then why? Yahweh was the only reason I made it this far in life. So yeah, so that's my breathtaking journey right now. And as Brother Alu, you know, mentioned that we have met at, we were all mentees, you know, of our Papa. I call him Papa Dr. Les Brown. I'm so grateful to this man. And God brought my vision to fruition. It was just a magical moment for my life when I met the man who transformed my life. I just want to tell you that dreams do come true. That was my dream, to be able to hold his hand, to be able to look him in the eye and tell him, thank you for transforming my life. Thank you for being a blessing to my life. And I love to do that with everyone, you know, who's God, you know, who God placed in my life. And so from a journey of losses, from I lost my father, went through a divorce, you know, losing my parents. And out of all that, you know, I became a number one best-selling author and international of my, this is my first solo project. I have 8 other anthologies. Oh my goodness. Sorry, excuse me. My Debo is not being nice. And so, yes, that's my journey. And it was what all that God has brought, you know, me through. I just had to believe in myself. You know, I just had to tell myself that, hey, you know, you have that faith, have faith in yourself, you know, and I had that faith in God. I had that unwavering faith in God to know that he will always bring me through it all. Excuse me. And that's how I made it this far in life. You know, the prayer, you know, there is power in prayer. There is power in prayer, and there is power in fasting, and there is power in forgiveness, you know, because with all that I went through, I had to learn to forgive myself. You know, I had to learn to forgive others, you know, and when you do that, God will open doors to your life. And I'm sharing, as always, I'm sharing this experience with you, you know, what forgiveness can really do to you. It will open those doors that you never thought it will be there for you. And the reason why I said forgiveness is a gift is because not everyone can forgive, you know. And so I just encourage you to have that heart to forgive. because what God has for you is only for you. And I just want to encourage you to believe that you are who you say you are, and you are who God says you are. So no matter what people say, no matter what kind of label that people label you as, who cares, right? Like Papa Les Brown said, that's none of your business. So when you are authentically you, be authentic with your journey, be transparent, just be you. You know, be the beautiful you, be the bold you, and be that amazing you, you know, to be that person, you know, to love on others, to be a blessing to other people. And so, you know, like I said, that is my story and the reason why I started writing my book, the reason why I started writing this book, because, you know, I love telling my story to share the glory of God and how he has brought me through in life. And the very first tip that I've always been using and will always be the first and the number one step that I use in anything that I do was allowing God to be that foundation, that cornerstone of my life in everything that I do. In my family, you know, in everything, he is the center of everything that I do. And everything I do, all the glory, everything that I do, it don't belong to me. And I want you to understand that too. It doesn't belong to you, okay? And it all belongs to him. And so that's why it's important for us to always, always give him the honor, praise, and glory. Because I, like I said, if it weren't for him, we won't be here today. So that's why I started writing my book, Heart of a Warrior, The Humble Journey of a Samoan Warrior. And, you know, I encourage you to write your story. Your story will be that blueprint. I know for me, I know that this book right here will inspire you. This book right here will empower you to rebuild your life. This book right here will make you step into your greatness. Yes. Look at that girl. Yes. So, you know, I encourage you to just write your story and just know that no matter what you go through in life, as long as you don't stay there, you know, God will make you his vessel, because I am a vessel of love and positivity. And so, you know, start telling your story, reach out, you know, to me, and I will be the one to help you, you know, get your story out there. And don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed to tell your story, because you're, like I said, your story will change somebody's life. So, yes.
Thank you very much, Talia. Thank you very much for sharing that powerful story. Well, you're telling your story, I'm sitting down here just thinking to myself, wow, that's amazing, and I love it. And I know everyone listening to it today really love your story, The Heart of a Warrior. This is a great title. And I just want, you know, you mentioned it in your, you know, story that dreams do come true. But I believe a lot of people out there think that dreams doesn't come true. They have so many dreams, but they think that, oh, dreams never come true, you know. I've dreamed of this, but I've never get it. But what will you tell someone out there? Because I know dreams do come true. I have a dream, and I have realized a lot of my dreams right now. And with God's mercy, today I am here interviewing people all around the world. This was
a dream for me.
Yeah.
Yes. God is using you in a mighty way.
Exactly. Sharing their story and inspiring. Even we're inspiring one person here today. That's huge.
Yes.
So what will you tell someone out there that dreams do come true and they should believe in themselves? They should believe in themselves to know that dreams do come true, and they should be patient with themselves that dreams do come true, because you are an example today that you were able to get up and write your story in a book, that you are inspiring many people around the world. And you also met your mentor, your godfather. Yes, life.
Yes.
I want you to tell the audience today that dreams do come true.
Man, yeah. Alu, like when you're telling me that, you know, I'm having the chills. And the reason why it's because I was sharing in my on Saturday night about dreams do come true. And so I came up with an acronym, you know, for dreams do come true about my journey. So the D for the dreams, you know, was that determination. I had to be, you know, with what you want in life, have that determination. You have it. You just got to go get it. You know, you just got to love yourself enough, fly. Look, I love my fly. First, love yourself. Love yourself enough to have that determination, you know, to know what you want. And then that R is the reset. You know, it's important for us. For me, it was critical in my journey to press that reset button. You know, it's okay. You know, it's always good to press that reset and say, you know, get yourself back together and everything. So write it down. I hope, you know, you are listening and taking notes. Like I said, you know, determination, reset, and E, I had to stay encouraged, you know, and I encourage you to stay encouraged. And that's how I got to writing this book, was that determination, pressing that reset button, you know, when I needed to, the encourage. And guess what? The A, have an attitude of gratitude. You can always have a good attitude, but having that attitude of gratitude, you know, gratitude is something special with my journey, because gratitude changed my life. And practice gratitude. It's a nice thing to do. So the A, yeah, and then M was the masterpiece, right? Like I say to myself, I am a masterpiece. I want you to write that down. I hope someone, you know, is listening to me and writing this down, you know, the acronym DREAMS, determination, reset, encourage, attitude of gratitude, masterpiece, you know, because you know why? We are a piece of the master. That's why I said to myself, I got this, you know, and then the S is sincere. Be sincere with what you do. Love what you do. You know, don't just like what you do, love what you do, because like I mentioned that earlier, and I will always continue to tell you that when you love what you do and you do it with all of your heart, that's when you know your purpose in life is aligned with God's calling in your life. So do that, right? So we got that determination, reset, encourage, attitude of gratitude, masterpiece, and sincere. So the do for me was that dedication. You know, I had to dedicate all my time for me, you know, because I only have me and I love myself enough. I continue to fly high. You know, first love yourself, dedicate everything that you want, dedicate yourself, dedicate your time, dedicate all that you want to be, you know, to birth your book out. You can do it. And the O was one of a kind. You know, I'm not just a one in a million. I am one of a kind because I am authentically me. And that's why I mentioned to you earlier, be authentic with your journey. Be authentic with yourself. You know, and it's a wonderful, wonderful thing to be authentically you. I always say I am free to be authentically me, whom God created me to be, because you cannot be duplicated. You are just one you. You are just the one person that God created all of us differently, right? And so own up to that, own up to your authenticity. And then the come for me, so we got it, right? Dreams do come true. So the C for me was the courage. I had to have that courage, you know, within me to make it through this far. There were many times that I want to give up, but I had to continue to keep that courage going, you know, and I encourage you to do the same thing. You know, so the O for me was overcoming. I had to tell myself, hey, I am an overcomer. I can overcome anything life is throwing at me. And I want you to know that you are an overcomer. You, no matter what life is throwing at you, because you love yourself enough, because, you know, you have faith, because God has blessed you with that courage and that power, that makes you an overcomer. And so, you know, the M is that mindset of a warrior, you know, having that positive mindset, that mindset of a champion, that mindset of a warrior, having that positiveness in your life, you know, and it makes a difference. So when you have that powerful mindset to know that, hey, this is what I really want, this is what I'm going to do, you know, I'm going to be that vessel, I'm going to be that servant, you can do it. And then the E is to empower. Just what, you know, this is what I'm doing now. I said to myself, you know what? I'm going to empower others. I'm going to inspire others, and I'm just going to love on others. So, yeah, so that's the dreams do come. And then true for me, T, take charge of my life. I took charge of my life on September 1st, 2020. And I want you to know that now, not tomorrow, not tonight, not later on, now is the time for you to take charge of your life and use all the gifts and tools that God has blessed you with. And the R is that resiliency. You know, that's when you know that no matter what life is throwing at you, push through, you know, you can do it. And that's what I am grateful to be, that resilient warrior, right? And you are one too. And the you for me, for true, is unafraid. I did everything. I got to where I am today because I was doing and I am living unafraid. Why? Because there's hope out there. Because there's love out there. You know, because I know that God will bring me through no matter what I go through in life. And I encourage you to have that kind of attitude, you know, to know that you can do anything, everything, unafraid. And E is enough. I know my worth. And I want you to know that you are enough, that you are worth of more than anything. So love yourself enough to be that change you want to see in life, right? So that every day, I hope someone wrote all that down about the dreams do come true. And if not, it's okay. Because when I go back to, you know, to watch the replay, I will, you know, be glad to put that on there. But yes, that's how I was able to fulfill my dreams. That's how I was able to make my dream come true. And the main thing that made my dreams come true was my faith in myself. It was my faith in God. You know, it's just something about my faith. You know, when you believe in yourself, you know, and knowing that God will be, you know, the main one to see you through, no matter what you go through in life, that's what got me today. That's what got me to, you know, make my dreams come true. I have been dreaming. Let's talk about Les Brown, how I got to meet him. You know, I reached out, you know, to John Tallarico, where he knew we was coming. But when it was that moment, you know, when he came to, you know, I saw him speaking to Amina. And then I said to myself, you know, this is the time. So I got up and I kindly asked, you know, let John know that, you know, I got this book. This is my book. I bless, you know, Dr. Les, you know, with a copy of my book, you know, and, you know, John said, you know, follow me. And, you know, immediately I said to myself, that's what Jesus said. Follow me. And so, you know, we went there and I was blessed to be, when I got into the room to where, you know, Les Brown, you know, was in, I just, like, I had the chills. My emotions were just, you know, and it's all because I was feeling grateful, you know, that gratitude moment, knowing that your dream had came true. And then for me to sit there, and I haven't posted my video yet, you know, I'm still having it all to myself. I've been watching this video and I'm giving God all the honor, praise, and glory. I had to grab his hand and I asked him, I said, I would like to hold your hand to look him in the eye and tell him how grateful I am for him. And let me tell you something, everything that I envisioned, God brought my vision into fruition. And that's why I encourage you to believe in yourself, because I believe in you. You know, believe that no matter what, you will always have your dreams come true. Remember, determination, reset, encourage, attitude of gratitude, masterpiece, sincere, dedication, one of a kind, courage, overcome, mindset of a warrior, empowered, take charge of your life, being resilient, you know, unafraid and enough. Yes, you are enough. That's all, you know, I have for how I got to where I am today about dreams coming true. When you follow those, it's up to you to use it, but that I'm sharing with you how I got to have, you know, my dreams come true, how I became a 9-times international best-selling author, how I became, you know, the person I am today. I didn't just get here just to be getting here. It took a lot of hard work. It took a lot of dedication. It took a lot of commitment. And I encourage you to do the same thing. I am grateful. You know, always be grateful to the people who pour into you. I am grateful to every single soul who has touched my life in some kind of way. And so is you, Brother Alu. I am so grateful to you. I'm grateful for, you know, the sisterhood, the brotherhood, relationship, you know, the fellowship. I am grateful for it all. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Kelly. That was really powerful and profound. I really love it so much. And, you know, I think someone today will learn that dreams do come true.
Yes.
As you mentioned, with determination and being in love with yourself and believing yourself, have faith in yourself, that knowing that your dream will come true one day.
Right.
And then the other thing I wanted to ask you, Pelly, you know, the time that your husband passed away, you know, because a lot of people, you know, when things happen to them, they just go with them. When things went bad, go bad, they go with them. So how were you able to stay where you are and then pick yourself up from there and start your life all over again without your husband, raising 3 beautiful kids? How were you able to do that?
Like I said, it's my why. You know, I believed in myself that my why, I had to tell myself, you know, that my why is that big, that my why is that strong. And when I started my journey, my only why, you know, was we have 3 biological children, and then God blessed me with an extra blessing, you know, Isabella, who is Victoria's best friend. And I love her just like my own. So I always claim 4 children. I have my 4 children and my nieces, nephews, you know, everybody else's kids. And so, yes, but I have 4 beautiful children. And like you said, how was I able to do that? It was because, you know, I was grateful to my mom. My parents were still living at the time. And I wanted to quit. I wanted to get out of the army. And I did put in my paperwork to get out, but that wasn't God's plans. And I was thankful to have a prayer warrior, my mother. And I really miss her so much. And my mom was the main one, you know, that was pushing me, you know, to stay closer to God, to know that God will see me through. And so now, you know, and she has instilled all that love in me. And that's how I'm able to love on all of you, you know, because of how, you know, I was raised. And I, like I mentioned, you know, when I read from my book that, oh, my faith, you know, journey in my life to my parents and grandparents. And so it is because I just have that heart for my children, you know, and I believe, you know, that they deserve, you know, this life. And I just didn't want to go, you know, to when my husband passed, I didn't want to, you know, to go like to say that, hey, I don't want to be here either. You know, I just had to believe that my children deserve a life, you know, and someone to be here for them. And I am that proud mother for my children. And I'm grateful to God, you know, because it was really hard. When I tell you my life shattered and everything, like I really didn't know what to do. But when I allow God to be the foundation of my life has changed. Like, wanted to share, where is that picture? Oh yeah, so in 2018, I don't know if y'all can really see this, this is how I look. I can see. And can you see it?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But look at me now. But look at me now, right?
You're glowing. And, you're glowing.
And that's just, it's because God's grace upon my life, God's favor, that uncommon favor. And I encourage everyone to know that you have, you know, God's favor on your life. You know, I had to come to my, you know, to my senses to know that I am highly favored, that I am blessed by the highest. And when we speak life into ourselves, you know, it don't manifest itself, you know, and it's all because I believed in me, you know, and I'm grateful to my mentors and everyone who has poured into me for believing in me when there were times that I did not believe in myself. So believe in you because Pele believes in you.
Loving this, you know, conversation with you today. And it's so beautiful. You're sharing so much, Nagat. And I know someone will learn from you today and then say to themselves, if Pele can make it all the way here, to be able to write a book,
yes,
out of a warrior, and for it to be number nine bestseller in Amazon. That's great. That's something huge.
Yes.
And then, you know, we just pray for you to be here longer and longer to inspire millions of people out there. And also, what makes you bring that title out of you, the heart of a warrior?
What makes me what? Can you repeat
what
the question?
What makes you name your book, The Heart of a Warrior? Yet, what makes you give the title to your book, A Heart of a Warrior? You should have chosen any title, isn't it? Would you choose A Heart of a Warrior? What makes you choose that?
Through a lot in life, because it took a lot for me. You know, it took a lot of heart for me to make it through this far in life. And I want to encourage everyone that's listening in or the replay, you have that heart of a warrior. You know, you do, you know, to make it through anything. And so because you asked that question, the first title that I came up with was Beautifully Broken. And one of the publishers asked me why I wanted to name it that. I still might have to, you know, but, you know, have a book named that. And so I told him, because, you know, I have been broken in all aspects of life, you know, but yet I'm still beautifully broken. And then my uncle heard me you know, speak at one of the podcasts, and he said, you know what, why don't you change from beautifully broken to spirit of a warrior. So that was the title I started off with. But as I was writing my book, right, one Sunday morning, I woke up and that's what came to my mind. God placed the title of my book, Heart of a Warrior. And then I said to myself, yes, I said, it took a lot of heart for me to be where I am today. Because when you have a heart of a warrior, you can overcome anything. And that's how I came up with the title, because it took a lot of heart for me to get to where I am today. And anyone can do the same thing.
Absolutely. That's very, very beautifully said. And heart of a warrior, that's what you are. And you have a heart, a good heart, and you have love in you. And you mentioned that earlier as well. You always give love. Because yes, I believe if you don't have love in you, you cannot give it.
Right.
And it's in you, because I can tell, you know, we connected a while ago, but since then, we've been very good, you know, brothers and sisters.
Yes.
And I really love that. Yes. Thank you very much for that. And also, what will you tell to someone who just believes that it's because of their circumstances, that's why they are where they are?
Mm-hmm.
What will you tell that person today, that they should not put their blame on their circumstances? because you have overcome all your circumstances and then be here today, what will you tell that person? Because a lot of people blame everything on their circumstances, because of this, because of that, because of that. But you have overcome this, you can overcome that, and you are here today alive.
You know why, Alu?
What would you tell? Yes.
It's because I didn't allow my circumstances define who I am. You know, like I mentioned earlier, I am who I say I am, and, you know, I am who God says I am. So I just encourage everyone to know that don't let your circumstances don't define who you are. You know, your circumstances, it's a lesson learned. And that's what I'm great. You know, everything that I've been through, I am grateful for it all. I've learned to embrace all those imperfections. I embrace everything, the pain. God truly used my pain, you know, and he turned my pain into my purpose. And everyone to know that you're certainly grateful with the trials, you know, and tribulation. When you learn to be grateful, you know, with the challenges of life, you'll be like, man, I can do just about anything. Better yet, you can do anything and everything when you do just that. And so, yeah, I would love to, you know, answer any questions if any of our audience have any questions of me. And I just want to, you know, say thank you to everyone who's tuning in. And I want you to know that I love you and I'm grateful, you know, for your time and just for loving Pele.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, Pele. You know, listening to your story really give me so much goosebumps right now. And then I even said to myself, oh, I've not been what Pele have been through. I said to myself, if she can make it, you know, sometimes we go like, you know, life's like a roller coaster. Sometimes, especially right. We're in this, you know, journey of self-development. And I see some of many of us started together, but some of them are left behind. I ask myself, where are they? But I'm still here. Pele is still here and many others.
Yeah.
What it takes to have that type of courage in you not to give up on yourself. Because a lot of people don't even know, you know, they say, you know, you are lucky, or you are blessed, or you have this, you have that, you know. But a lot of people, even in the self-development journey, some of them have already give up. It takes a lot out of us. I know that myself.
Right.
Sometimes, you know, I go through the roller coaster, but I have to just keep on going. Having those whys on top of me, knowing that this is why I have to be here.
Right.
And recently I got married, blessed with a beautiful wife and a beautiful son.
Congratulations.
4 months. Yeah, exactly. When I look at him, you know, he's my big boy, so cute and beautiful, you know, handsome boy. And when I look at him, I just feel in my heart, wow, like this is a duplication of me. So this is even giving me more motivation to work on the thing that I really want to have in my life. And we only have like 9 minutes to go. So what will you tell someone, at least the few minutes that we have, your final words to the audience? Someone out there, maybe who is going through sickness.
Yes, thank you so much.
You know,
I just want to share.
Who've been separated by their family, you know, and there's a lot of things that people are going through right now. What will you tell people out there, your last words of wisdom?
Yes. So thank you for that. And, you know, thank you. It has been an amazing, you know, time with you. And I just want everyone to know, when we're talking about family and how some families, you know, are not together. And like I mentioned earlier about the power of forgiveness and, you know, just have that heart to forgive. Debo, come here. Excuse my dog. So just have that, you know, just have that heart of forgiveness to forgive. But I want to share with everyone the two words that I live by. And if anyone is listening, I want you to write this down. You know, live and love. you know, live and love. That's how I'm living my life right now. I'm just living life, you know, because tomorrow is never promised. And I am just loving life. I love myself. You know, I'm loving life. I love what I do. And that's how I'm living. Those two words I live by on a daily basis. I didn't have those two words before when I was going through all my trials and tribulations in life. But now, you know, God has healed me. Now that God has blessed me, you know, to be a blessing to others. And those are the two words I love to live by. And I just want to gift everyone, you know, with my heart and my love. You know, every day, it doesn't matter where we are in life. Just know that I love you and just know that I am here. You can reach out to me. And that's what happened when at the breakthrough event. I'm so grateful to John Tallarico and Fernandez for hosting that event, because it was so much love in the building, you know, when all the Power Voice family came together, when, you know, Dr. Les Brown, you know, came. This man brought all of us together, like brought everyone from all walks of life. And what an amazing, you know, work of one person that brought everyone together. And so, yes, live and love and just gift the people. I encourage you to gift your loved ones with your heart and with your love. And I think this will be my third time saying the same thing about, you know, doing everything with your heart, doing everything with your love. And when you do that, that's when you know your purpose is aligned with God's calling in your life. You know, I love it when you do things with your heart and your love, because you know what, when you do that, you're not expecting anything in return, because God sees your heart that, hey, I am doing this wholeheartedly. You know, I am doing this because I just got so much love, you know. And when you don't expect anything in return from the people that you're doing something for, guess what? It's okay. God will bless you more than what that person you were expecting something from, right? And so, you know, those are my final words, you know, for our, you know, session today. And, you know, just continue to be inspired by the person in the mirror and continue to fly high. First, love yourself, because if you don't love yourself, you will not love anybody else, right? And all that we know. So, you know, once again, thank you, you know, Brother Lou, for, you know, this blessing and for, you know, this time. And I'm just so grateful. You know, I love you. Thank you, Sister Fatima. I know you, you know, you at work, but just being on your platform, I am blessed. I'm humbled and I'm honored. And once again, I want to thank all of our, you know, audiences, but I just want to, you know, give a big shout out. I always got to shout out my coach, shout out my publisher, the woman who made my dream come true as a published author, you know, the one and only Tanya Coley. You know, and so, yes, and I'm grateful to my photographer who took this picture, Mr. Ed Brown. Yes, and I'm just grateful to everyone, you know, my congresswoman, Fatali Amua Amata, you know, she was the one that endorsed my book, and to Sister Yashika. She wrote the foreword for my book, and I have a lot of people who has been a blessing to this book. I want to thank each and every one of you, you know, because I didn't, you know, make it here this far by myself. You know, I have a whole village, you know, that were pouring into me. And like, I encourage you, pour into those who pour into you, and be grateful for those who love on you, because I am grateful for each and every one of you who has touched my life, you know, any kind of way. And so, yes, I'm grateful to God for this connection. Connect with me. If you want a signed copy, you know, you can inbox me and I'll share with you. And my book is found on Amazon. And so, yeah, it's your choice. You just inbox me. But don't forget to get this book. This book will change your life. Yes, indeed, it will change your life. So, yes. So you can reach me, connect with me. You know, my website is peleinspire.com and Pele Hunkin on Facebook and Pele Inspire on Facebook and on Instagram and TikTok, Pele Inspire. So yes, I would love to connect with you. I would love to go into details, you know, with you of how I got, you know, this far in life, because I would love, you know, to help you through, and I will meet you right where you are.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Pele. And I've seen that, Andy, I've just seen all your links here, which is really
grateful. Oh, thank you, Andy.
Yes, Andy is amazing. Yes.
Yes, yes, she is.
Yes, you just share your links and everything here. So at least I'm telling someone out there, you can get that book, Heart of a Warrior. Yes. Is it also on Amazon?
Yes, it's on Amazon too. Yeah, but like I said, amazing. If you want a signed copy, mm-hmm. you know, inbox me directly.
Yes. So inbox Pele directly, and then she yes. will get you a signed copy to you. And this book will really help you to overcome, yes. you know, all that, you know, hardship and challenges that you're facing right now. Because I right. think people definitely need these moments. Because as Bob Marley said, you know, why will he take a break when the journalist asks him, why right. would you take a break? Because they just want to kill you the last time in your own home. He right. said, no, because the evildoers never take a break.
Right.
So us coming here in this amazing platform, sharing every day a story that can inspire someone and motivate yes. someone, for someone to say to themselves, yes, I have another life to live. I cannot just put the blanket on myself. I cannot just give up and die. No, I have a story to tell. I have a book to write.
Yes.
I have a song to sing. Yes. So thank you very much for having you today. It's been a great
yes,
pleasure.
Yes, thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Today and then sharing your story.
Yes. All right. Love you all. Bye for now.